Welcome to Meri Real Life. On this show, we try and sort of look at what it means to be an actor in the age of social media. And especially an actor with a graph like yours. In what? In 3 years, Masaan was 2015. In 3 years, you've gone from being the poster boy for independent cinema to a leading man in Karan Johar's Takht. It's an incredible success story. Do you ever feel, Vicky, that you're like living some kind of Bollywood surreal star life, some kind of fantasy?
I definitely feel I'm living my dream every day when I wake up in the morning and I know that I have to go on a film set. That is what I keep working hard for. A film set is what I believe, I mean, that is paradise for me. And if I get to live that dream every day of my life, it's just, I mean, I thank my stars, I thank God for it. With the way, like you mentioned, the journey has been in these past 3 years, it's been beyond my own belief. Like I keep saying, you know, ki kai, koi agar mujhe kehta na ki, like in 2015 when Masaan released, that I'll give you a blank sheet of paper and you write down how you want your next 3 years to be. I don't think I would have been able to write it so beautifully, you know, but I really feel blessed that it's happening this way.
But you know what I find interesting, Vicky, is that even though the circumstances around you, of course the film set and the acting and the craft is the core and that remains the same, right? But the circumstances around you are getting more and more sort of fantastical, more and more kind of what we associate with stardom, right? But your presence online, your social media, especially your Instagram, is very much about keeping it real. I mean, you posted this picture. Guys, this is Vicky doing an audition.
Oh, yeah.
I think perhaps to let people know that it's not overnight. I mean, you put in the time. It doesn't just happen that you wake up one day and you're where you are, right? And then there's this other picture that I love. This is a picture of Vicky.
That's my first time on a film set.
First time on a film set with Hrithik Roshan on the sets of Fizza. So, why is this important? Why is it important to let people see the reality?
I'll be very honest, I enjoy Instagram. I really enjoy. It's not for the people, it's something very personal for me. And people ask me who handles your digital PR and who's handling your Instagram. I'm like, nobody's handling.
Doing it yourself?
I'm doing it myself and I randomly talk to people over DMs also.
Really?
I wish them birthdays and I
Note
talk to them. and I talk to them, but they don't take me seriously. They're like, your PR is doing a great job. I'm like, no guys, it's me, it's Vicky Kaushal. And now, how to prove them to on a DM that it's me? Because I write it's me. And they're like, yeah, it's me too. But I really like that. I really like that connect. And I mean, I feel like what makes me real is my imperfections. And I really don't shy away from them. Because what makes me unique in my own little way would be my imperfections. So I kind of try to embrace them. I try to make them my hero material and just live with it. These are the pictures that I'm very, very proud of. I'm extremely proud of. That picture was sent to me by a casting director's assistant who's my friend. He sent to me because he was going through his database for his new ad film that he was casting.
The audition picture.
And in his database, he found this picture. And he sent it to me. And I was like, thank you so much for sharing this. And he just sent me that, you know, this is where you started from. And it's so important to remember where you started from. Because, I mean, the glint that I had over there, and I still had that bag with me. And that bag was a bag where I used to have formal clothes, traditional clothes, and a trimmer with me. Because, yaar, ki kahin
bhi... Beard trimmer also.
Haan, beard trimmer also. Halanki beard itni thi nahi tab meri.
Haan, waise zyada nahi hai.
But सारे ये weapons लेके मैं चलता था कि कहीं भी कोई भी आप बोलोगे कि ठीक है दिवाली की ad है ठीक है traditional पहन के खड़े हो गए executive ad है ठीक है formals पहन के खड़े हो गए so I used to have that bag with me and that used to be my favorite t-shirt then and this slate I mean I'm sure you guys know the importance of this slate I mean maybe in a sleep also we used to be like Am I fit for the audition? Left profile, right profile? So, these were beautiful days, but it's scary now. You know, it really scares me. Looking back at these days, it really scares me. But
why?
Now, in retrospect, it feels very difficult. It feels like that was, like I said, you know, when I asked you guys, like, are you from an acting school? And you said yes. It's a very scary time because that's when the road ahead looks very, I don't know, it, firstly, you can't even see the road ahead. And then you're like, the destination to bhooli jao. Destination to bahut hi kahin aage dikh raha hai. You don't know how you'll reach there. And every day you have to wake up, you have to self-motivate, you have to step out, you have to meet people, you have to go for auditions. Face your insecurities, face your complexes every day. Face your inhibitions every day and fight. Like I said this in the last interview also that we did, that when you're starting off on this journey of becoming an actor, it's the most, I mean, you are, you can fall any minute. It's, you're the most fragile when you're in, at that stage. And I was like that too. But that is only in retrospect I'm thinking. But tab mujhe nahi lagta tha. Tab I was like, ki every day utke ye karna hai, to karna hai. Like, wo tha. Like, I was a horse with those blinders that I have to go. At 11 o'clock in the morning, I have to leave my house. That I knew. Jaake, I knew these specific spots jahan pe auditions hote hai. I used to go. I used to do, kai baar auditions nahi bhi hote the. Once there was a day when I had stood in line for an hour and a half for a Bhojpuri film, which I knew I'm not going to do it. But us din koi audition nahi ho raha tha. And I used to feel ki jis din koi audition nahi hua, I used to feel ki yaar mera din productive nahi hua. And mujhe ye hota tha kahin bhi koi audition de do, mujhe karna hai nahi karna, that I'll take a call. But it was very important for me to know that the casting guys feel that I have it in me. I need to get that call ki you're selected, and then I can say ki okay, this is not what I want to do. But that call used to motivate me. That you have it in you, you know, we selected you for this. So that Bhojpuri, I still remember that Bhojpuri scene, they had written the script and they had pasted that page out of that room, outside the room. And I read that and it was a very typically, wo mandir mein jaake 80s wala scene ki khush to bahut honge tum wala ki, you know, ghantiyan baja ke you abusing the god and ki tumne kya kiya mere saath, aisa tha. And I had exactly the kind of smirks you had now. And I was like, ye kya hai? And then I passed out and I was like, what if I had to convince an audience with this, with these lines? What if? Aise bhi main kuch nahi kar raha aaj, koi audition ho nahi raha. Let me just do this. And I stood in line for like an hour and a half. And I went there and I gave the audition. And I felt good. Halaki ye alag baat hai ki mujhe uske liye bhi call wapas nahi aaya. Which I was like, yaar, iske liye bhi mujhe nahi call aaya, yaar, you are selected.
They must be kicking themselves now. You know, Abhishek Bachchan introduced me to a new term, Nepo Kids.
Nepo Kids, yeah.
Nepo Kids. Nepo Kids are the Bollywood kids, yeah. Right? They're industry children. You're also a Nepo Kid. But you're not one of those kids who grew up and went to these fancy birthday parties. And, you know, you grew up in a, you know, small house in Malad and sort of worked your way up. Do you think this background is what enables you to sort of stay grounded and stay real, even as your circumstances become more unreal?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I was born in a house which was probably 1/4 of this space over here, which didn't have a separate bathroom or a kitchen. There was one mattress, there was one mooda, and one aate ka dabba. That's it. That's what my mom says. Like, ek bhagwan ki photo bhi nahi thi. So mom, after getting married to my dad, that's the first shopping thing that she did was, ek bhagwan ki photo hi rakh lo yahan ghar mein. And so that's where I was born. And uske baad mein, it's all been dad's efforts and dad's, it's been his journey. But he's made sure that while growing up, we know, as kids, we know what his journey has been like. I know how every piece of furniture has come to my house. He's made sure we know the difference between necessity and luxury. He's told me, I'll provide you with the necessity. Luxuries, aapko khud kamani hai.
But Vicky, social media also in a sense is a performance, right?
Of course, sometimes, yeah.
Yeah, you are putting a version of yourself out there.
Of course.
How much do you think about it and how much is it in the moment and what you're feeling right there?
To be very honest, it's very scary sometimes. Sometimes you can't just say something, what you felt like. Then there'll be repercussions and you'll be held accountable to it even after years.
Of course.
That, you know, in 2004 you said this. And you're like, I was a different person. I don't know what I was doing back then, you know. But you will be held accountable for that. And sometimes there's a responsibility on you if you're a public figure also that you need to have an opinion. Why?
Correct.
And even if I have an opinion, it's my call if I want to make it public or not. I only want to discuss it with my family. It's my call.
When you're tweeting or posting on Insta, is it just what you are in that moment? Or do you think five times, you know?
In general life, mein, there's something that I follow that agar aap kuch achha bol rahe ho, exaggerate. Exaggerate by saying that I feel ki agar aap 10 guna bhi achha bol do kisi ke liye because you genuinely feel it, there's no harm in it. Mm. But if there's anything critical that you want to say, do it in a personal way. Pick up a phone, call that person and say that, not right. on a social media platform. Mm.
And how much do you design the pictures you're putting on Instagram?
Not much. I don't put filters, huh. but brightness, contrast, adjust.
Utna kar leta hai. So, do you think, Vicky, it's easier or harder because of social media to be an actor today?
It depends. It's very subjective. It's how you take it.
What do you mean?
It's like I said, there is pressure, but it's always very subjective. How much of that pressure you take it? It's not necessary.
How much you listen?
You have to keep it in mind that this is not the real world. This is the real world. You know, that's not the real world. Mm. So, ye hoga, and it's a part of the real world now, that virtual world. But it depends. Aap kitna pressure lete ho, kitna nahi lete ho. Some people I have met that unko it's the pressure ki yaar aaj kuch post nahi kiya.
Huh. Like, it's compulsory. You feel, huh? Correct.
Like, and you're like, to usse kya ho jayega?
Huh.
And then sometimes you see pictures of, like, people posting a picture which is like a normal picture, and then there's like a paragraph of hashtags. And then you're like, but hashtag actor's life, hashtag dream, this, I don't know. So you're like, but it's okay if that's what they find happiness.
See, it is part of your job now,
it
right?
It is. But then, wohi hai na ki ye mera job nahi hai. My job is between action and cut. You know, this is not my job. This is just like on the sides, some fun, some extracurricular activity that is going on.
Hmm.
But it's not my job. My job is between action and cut, and no matter if I don't do good at my job, no matter how many hashtags I use, no matter how many filters I use, nothing's gonna happen. Mm-hmm. I'm not gonna get likes, I'm not gonna get followers, nothing's gonna happen. The equation is that simple. You fail there, you'll fail here. You rise there, you'll rise here. That's it.
You know, I read in an interview, Anurag Kashyap said about you that in the beginning, when you first started and you were giving these auditions, a lot of people said, great, the acting's all in place, but you're not hero material.
Yeah. To be very honest, when I started off, I had this pressure. And it came from my own complexes that I'm lanky, curly hair, crooked teeth, not a fair complexion guy, not the chocolate boy hero. So, ye complexities the mere. And that's why I always never had the confidence of saying, like shaking hands with somebody, and this is when I just started off, shaking hands with somebody that I'm Vicky Kaushal, I want to be an actor. And
you so couldn't say that to anyone?
I couldn't say that. Although I was doing my acting course, I was doing everything I could to become an actor, but it didn't come as confidently as I would have wanted to.
But why, you thought they would say, ki nahi, tu kya actor banega, like that?
Not that. Huh. Apne mere internal insecurities the. Ki yaar nahi main karke prove kar dunga
but bolunga nahi.
I don't want those judgmental eyes towards me because ye mere sath ho chuka hai, like I've and so it's a cheap thrill of my life. So I've gone for an audition when I was like doing the rounds and knocked the door, said am I fit for the audition, and he looks at me from top to bottom, and that room was this big and it had some like 50-100 boys in it. All glad drive model, like, main aisa kehta ki sare handsome ladke aaj yahi hain. And then he looked at me from top to bottom and he's like, D.O. ke ad. So that was an indication that you're not fit. But mana to nahi kiya tha. So main bhi besharam. And he got D.O. ke ad. And then I was like, sir, am I fit for the audition? And then he's like, chal, theek hai, aaja. Tujhe pata lag jayega what I meant by that. And I went in, and then obviously it was that typical remove your t-shirt, girls falling on you type of an audition. So it was actually that bathroom ki ceiling phatengi tumhare upar se aur ladkiyan girengi, and you have to imagine, oh, D.O.
Matlab ladkiyan bathroom ke ceiling mein ghusi hui hain.
Pata nahi kya hai, bas girengi. So I was like, okay, and I gave that audition. Lanky fellow, bare-bodied, and like, haan, haan, kiya. And but that stayed in my head. That scan of his eyes from top to bottom stayed in my head.
Mm.
And this year there's this Dio brand that came my way that they wanted me on it. And I was like, paise chodo. I was like, sab kuch chodo, main ye kar raha hu. Because I wanted that loop to...
to close. Have
its closure in my own life. There was a time when I was scanned from top to bottom for a Dio ad. Now, this is the time when a Dio ad came to me and I'm doing a Dio ad and same old stuff.
Good for you.
The only difference was that in this ad, there were men falling on me. But it's okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, but yeah, I thank God for it.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Tell me now that there are great expectations from you. Is there now pressure to maybe, at least, you know, online or virtually, sort of present an image of perfection? You know, the sort of the GQ model, the Glad Rags model. Do you have to deal with that? Like, how good am I looking? Like, does success bring those in?
It might, but maine liya nahi abhi tak.
No?
No, because with the thing, way things are going, I have also realized, by posting such pictures, I've also realized that people, through these platforms of social media, they really want to look at who you are. That image they get to see on screen also, during events also, whatever, different platforms, but through social media, they really appreciate if you're really presenting your true self. And I feel it's fun when I get to do that. Obviously, it's not just the candid pictures, not just pictures like this I post. I, of course, post portfolio pictures and I post like good shots and like the GQs and the whatever. Mm-hmm. I do that. But I don't take that pressure that now that you are somebody, then you have to make an image or like, you know, form an image on social media. That's everybody's just clapping and oh, wow, oh, cute, how cute. And yehi hota rahe. It's not that. I try and present what I feel like doing then, what I say, like what I feel like communicating then, is just that. I don't really take that pressure. But there is that pressure.
Of course there is. Do you look at other actors' Insta feeds? Do you stalk anyone?
Yeah, a lot of them. A lot of them. I follow nahi karta, but random stalking kafi chalti hai. Yeah, a lot of them. Ab mujhe yaad nahi aa raha, like, I really find a few pages very entertaining.
Like who?
I really love Diljit Dosanjh.
Yeah, he's
on social
fab.
Media. He's fab.
Like, he's just aced it.
He's real.
Yeah.
And there's this page called 9gag also. I really like it. Like, good change. So, yeah.
You know what I like is when you do post the slightly vain pictures, like this one.
Yeah.
This is Vicky in the gym. But his caption is modesty on point.
See? I'm aware of it.
Right. So you're willing to poke fun at yourself.
Yeah.
You know, how, so what's
see, the, this, I'll be very honest.
Please,
this
guys.
This specific
note
type of body, I get like one evening in a year.
evening?
Yeah. And I know like my trainer, like he bajaoed me for like 2 hours and then... And this was, oh my God, so this, I have to share, this was an evening before I shot that Dio ad. I had to be this.
Correct.
And yeah, I was fully like Dio ki ad mili, and I gave you the whole build up how important that Dio ad for me was. And I was like, I need to crack something and I need to be this. So an evening before I was just rehearsing with my, and thankfully the gym was empty, so I could do all of this. But then, yeah. But ek din agar body banti hai pure saal mein, toh main chhodunga nahi moga. Then I'll post it.
Tell me, how do you process the negativity? You know, especially artists get slammed. Like you were saying, people say, but why aren't you saying this? Or why are you saying this? How do you process all of that? Because it is an interactive medium.
Yeah. If it makes sense to you, if it really makes you go like, haan yaar, ye maine socha nahi tha. He's got a point or she's got a point. Then you process it in the right direction. That ki, haan, what can I do?
But you read everything?
I do.
Really?
Everything.
Wow.
Everything. I read every review. I read every comment. I read everything. But if it is something where you feel, yaar, haan, theek hai. Because it's also very easy to sit in your pajamas in the bedroom and just comment ki, yaar, kya bakwas hai?
Correct.
Without any constructive feedback.
Yeah.
You know, but if you come across a constructive feedback, you really put a thought into it. You really try and make a difference into that. That's why I love reading reviews also. Because reviews, and I'm not saying 10 out of 10 are constructive feedbacks or constructive reviews, but most of them are.
Do you think we become too obsessed?
Yeah, yeah, totally. And sometimes you just feel like, ki, yaar, I want to quit social media.
Yeah.
But then you're like, nah, I'll miss it.
So what are your rules? Like, how do you control it instead of letting it control you?
I don't know. And I'll be very honest. I'm not in a position where I can confidently say that I control it. It's a mix of both. I am in the middle ground where I know that it's also controlling me. And I'm somewhere also controlling that. Like my friends around me call me an Insta addict.
Insta addict?
Yeah. Because I like reading comments. I like reading stuff. I like reading the reaction. I like reading all of that. So, but that's scary also. So I won't, I will admit that I'm not completely in control of social media. Social media is also in control of me. But we are working. We are working towards a better relationship.
Okay. What are your rules for keeping it real? If you can't control it, at least let's keep it real, right? How do you do that?
But I think that comes from who you are. If you like to keep it real in your real life, you will keep it real in your virtual life also.
You'll be authentic.
Yeah. But I think that goes in sync. Mm. If that's not happening in real life, it won't happen in your virtual life also. So firstly, you have to bring that change in your real life. You have to be real in your real life.
Mm.
You have to start embracing your imperfections in your real life. And when that happens, you'll be confident to do that on social media as well.
And it is what makes us who we are.
We are.
Yeah, absolutely. With that, let's open it up to questions. Who has questions, guys?
This is my favorite part. Really.
Hi, Vicky.
Hi.
You spoke about there are pressures to social media.
Anji.
And you are addicted to Instagram. But there are so many other different platforms on social media. Yeah. Are you on them because you're expected to be, or you feel the pressure that everyone else is, so you have to be on those platforms
no,
as well?
No. So I'm only on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. Snapchat kabhi samajh nahi aaya mujhe. So, nahi, I've never used those. I get so confused. Are aa nahi raha, are. Too much work, no? Too much work, yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
And plus, my selfie game is really weak. So, Snapchat pe kya karunga?
Hi, Vicky. So my question was that if you would not have been acting as you are doing right now, so if not actor, then what would you have been?
I would have definitely been somebody who's contributing to filmmaking. Somebody who's there on a film set, be it a spot boy to anybody, but definitely related to films because I can't see myself anywhere else. I mean, I am really the best version of myself when I'm on a film set. So, it would be related to films, making films, but I don't know what. I can't really pinpoint that.
No, you did study engineering.
I did, but that I was just going with the flow. I mean,
there's no thought in it.
No, never. And till today, I'm not that guy who plans, who knows what he's going to be 5 years down the line or what he wants to be 5 years down the line. I don't know.
Hi, Vicky. I want to ask, how was your experience with Raju Hirani, sir? Means, kuch kissa ho jaye aur kuch gyan bhi mil jaye.
He is one of the most beautiful human beings I've ever come across. The films you watch, I think it's just an extension of who he is as a person. And that's the most beautiful part that I experienced during working with him. Because that's what I realized, ki aap jaise ho, wo kaam mein aapke jhalakta hai. That sincerity, that honesty, that warmth. You feel it in his work also. And one episode I will never forget is when he gave me the narration of Sanju. It was firstly the most amazing narration I've ever gone through. So the whole process was I was called by the casting director for the audition of Kamli. I went there and I gave a test. At that time I was shooting for another film. So it happened like in between shoot and rehearsal and this and that. I was running. I had just 45 minutes and I gave like 3 tests. And I was really nervous that, you know, a director like Raju sir would judge me based on these 3 takes only. And I wasn't really convinced. So I was like, ki kahin ek aur mauka mil jaye yaar audition karne ka, shanti se, fursat se. So, but then I got a call saying ki you have to go and meet Raju sir in his office. So I was like, okay, I don't know, kya hoga, fingers crossed. And I go there and so I get to know that it's a narration meeting. I was like, okay. So I was sitting on the sofa and he came in and he sat and firstly he was late. And late like by 10 minutes. And that's not even like late in film industry. And the way he was apologizing was ki mujhe guilt ho gaya. Ki yaar Raju sir itna apologize kyun kar rahe hain, nahi sir, mat karo. And then he was very sweet because he sometimes ends up calling you sir. Sir, sorry, later. I said, sir, aap mat bolo mujhe. And then he just sits on the sofa. He removes his specs and he starts narrating the story. There's no laptop. There is no script.
It's all in his head.
It's all in his head. Dialogue by dialogue, moments by moments, and he will stand up, he will sit down, he will cry, he will laugh, and I am crying and I am laughing, and there was no interval. It was 3 hours straight Sanju film that I saw. And I was blown away. But the worst part was that I didn't know that am I doing the film or not. And I was like, ab to mujhe karni, ab nahi bol doge, toh main toh gaya. Main toh matlab, I will be very sad. And then I'm like, you know, then I'm really like, no, it's great. And yeh, woh, I'm jumping and I'm crying and I'm laughing and everything is happening. And then I'm like, toh sir, so where to go from here? Am I doing it or nahi? And then he's like, arre, sir, kar rahe ho, isle toh main narration de raha hu, thoda ro raha. I'm like, oh, main kar raha hu. Okay, oh, great. Oh, okay. So that meeting was really memorable for me. And it was very special for me, Raju sir, to say that you're part of my film.
That's so lovely.
But he's beautiful. He's a beautiful, beautiful, and so much to learn from him.
Super.
Thank you. Sorry, that was a very long answer.
No, but Vicky, you've been so great. Thank you. Really. So lovely. So lovely to listen to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you.
Thank you for taking out time for this. Thank you.